So let me start with the global prize, the global award, in closing the gender gap, which will go to Iceland.
Dear host, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. I want to start by saying that thank you on behalf of Iceland for this award. In Iceland, as you can see from this award, gender equality is among the best, and that is something we are really, really proud of. And the most positive thing about that fact, that gender equality is at such a high standard in Iceland, is that it is greatly appreciated by the general public themselves. It is greatly appreciated both by men and by women, of course. But the reason behind this consensus, and that big consensus about that issue, is still to be explained, of course, by independent, strong, and extra courageous women. Not only have we had women president, we have here with us today our former prime minister. I want to ask you to give her applause. Johanna Sigurðardóttir. But also, our success can be explained by extra active mass of Icelandic women, the thing that Halla was talking about this morning. Icelandic women should be the owner of this award. Dear guests, when I try, and I often am asked, and I often try, to describe Iceland's success regarding gender equality, I sometimes use the comparison of the times when my mother was born, when I was born, and the reality my two young daughters face today. When my mother was born in 1945, there was no woman an MP, no woman in parliament, and no woman had a seat in a local government. When I was born in 1966, she was really, really young when she decided to have me, much had changed, but still only one woman as an MP and one active member of parliament as a woman. As a young girl, I was really interested in public debate. I watched TV, I watched all the other MPs, and I thought this would be something I would really like to do for the rest of my life. But I never thought about it seriously. It was for me simply a man's world. And the message to a young girl like me was constantly, don't even think about it seriously to get in there. But now, 40 years later, I have two daughters, one is 9 and the other one is 15. Their reality is much different. Over 40% of Icelandic MPs are women. They have seen role models through the years, such as the one I mentioned here earlier. And when you ask a young girl, seriously in Iceland, when you ask them if they think they have less opportunities, or they can have a different future, or they can do something less than the boys they grow up with, they seriously don't understand the question. For them, equality is such a usual matter, they simply don't understand the question. And that's the beauty of the whole thing. But ladies and gentlemen, 2015 will mark the 100-year anniversary for women's voting right in Iceland. As expected at that time, you can imagine the time, 1915. There wasn't the same consensus in Iceland then about granting women the right to vote. And I'm going to tell you a little story about Icelandic men. And let me add to begin with that they're really great. All in all, they're really great. But they've been trying to change their mental states about equality for a long time. But when the issue was discussed during a session in the Icelandic parliament at that time, some male MPs, because there was no woman, said frankly that although women were excellent, excellent in some matters, they were of course not able to handle a political office. One MP said that he was extra positive towards equality for women, but added, I guess with extra kindness, that even though he knew women were less intelligent and usually had less judgment of serious issues, this was not all negative, since women made this up with some other really nice qualities. That was the discussion in 1915. And this goes to show us that 100 years is a short time in human history. So we have to look at how much has changed, how much we have gained, but more importantly, how much can change and how much we can change in the coming years. That is why I want to add in the end, ladies and gentlemen, that despite the success we have in Iceland, we still face some challenges. One of these challenges I would like to address shortly and take it to a special concern. That is the fact that trust in politics, trust in politicians, and even trust in democracy itself has declined around the world. This is the same in Iceland, as I'm sure it is in your countries. And in order for our societies to work, in order for us to do great things for the people of our societies, we need people to regain trust in politics and trust in democracy. But that will not happen, dear guests. It will not happen unless we change the way we do politics. We need greater variety of people to take part. We need people with new ideas about democracy to take part. We need politics to reflect the society we work for, and we desperately need more women to take part. This is my vision. This is my dream of a different and better politics. Politics where cooperation for the greater good is on the top of our list, where the winner does not take it all, where we work across party lines, and politics that really respects democracy. Politics that are not seen, as politics has been seen for a long, long time, as a male-dominated battlefield, but an important stage of public service where we all try to do our best and work together for the greater good. And believe me, dear guests, this important change that is the foundation of our democracy will only be made if more women take part in politics. And if more women allow themselves to do politics the way they want to do politics. So, we don't simply need to get in. We don't simply need to get into politics. We need to do more than take part. We need to take control. We need to womanize politics. Dear guests, I know this dream of mine can come true. I know it simply because the dream of a further equality between women and men has become true. And by doing so, our countries and the world will become a better place. And in the end, I would like to add, and thank you so much for giving this recognition to Iceland. There is on the table over there a little gift from Iceland. It's of course our country, and it says, a little gift from Iceland. I encourage you to take that, to hang it on your Christmas tree if you have one. You can then hang it on somebody's tree or what's it. And please, when you look at it, remind yourself that we can do great things for our great nations if we encourage women to take further part. Thank you.
So I'm now proceed following this very focused remark, very encouraging. Let me give you this prize, which is the Global Award.